Welcome to Hydrogeology 101, Key Concepts. Today I'd like to talk about how the sorting of sediments affects the density and porosity of a sandy gravel. We're going to be doing a scientific experiment in my kitchen involving a pint glass. Okay, let's have a look at how sorting affects porosity. Porosity is the ratio of void spaces to the total volume. In the well-sorted sediment on the left, all the particles are of similar size, and we can expect quite a high porosity. If the sediment is poorly sorted, it means that the particle sizes are mixed, and the finer material will fill up the pore spaces between the larger material. This will reduce the overall porosity, as you can see here on the right. Good sorting means high porosity, while poor sorting means low porosity. To investigate this theory, I went down to the river to collect a sample of river sediments. I found some nice rounded pebbles and some very coarse sand, mostly composed of limestone. Here's a picture of our pebbles in the pint glass and the coarse sand that we collected. Is it really possible to fit all that coarse sand into the pore spaces between the pebbles? Let's find out in the video.
Hello, my name is Andreas. Today I'm going to talk about porosity. Here's a sample of gravel I collected this morning down from the river. You can see there's quite a few spaces in between these pebbles. I've tried to fill it right to the top. What we're going to do now is mix it with this finer material, which is a very coarse sand, like this. Whoa. And I'm see if I can put it back in the glass. I haven't cheated too much. There's only one or two pebbles on the floor. What you can see is that most of our fine material has managed to take up the spaces between our little pebbles here. And this illustrates sorting in a sediment, because the smaller particles can fill up the spaces between the big particles.
Our sample is a poorly sorted sandy gravel composed mostly of limestone particles.
And let's weigh and see how much it weighs. It's zero. The weight is 1.419 kilograms.
Let's calculate the density of our sandy gravel. The density of a substance is its mass per unit volume. The symbol we often use is the lowercase Greek letter rho, and mathematically it is calculated by dividing the mass by the volume. Mass is usually expressed in kilograms and volume in cubic meters. So our density is in units of kilograms per cubic meter or grams per cubic centimeter. The sample of sandy gravel in the pint glass has a net weight of 1.099 kilograms. After we subtract the weight of the glass. Notice how the weight has increased quite a bit since we've added the sand to the gravel. So it's gone up from 0.8 of a kilogram to over 1 kilogram because of the addition of the sand. We measured the volume of the glass by weighing how much fresh water can be added to an empty glass. It works out at 0.577 kilograms, which is the same as 0.577 liters. Applying the formula for density, we can calculate the density of our dry sandy gravel. So what we do is we take the weight of the sandy gravel in the glass, 1.099, and we divide it by the volume of the glass, 0.577. And it works out at 1.905 grams per cubic centimeters, or 1,905 kilograms per cubic meter. We can estimate the porosity of the sandy gravel from its density. If we assume that limestone has a density of 2.711, we can calculate the porosity of the sandy gravel assuming that it's made mostly of limestone. A block of limestone with a 0% porosity would weigh 2,711 kilograms per cubic meter. If the limestone had a porosity of 50%, its density would be 0.5 times times 2711 kilograms, which would make 1355.5 kilograms per cubic meter, assuming, of course, that all the void space in the sample is filled with air. We can calculate the porosity of the sandy gravel by this formula here, where we do 1 minus the ratio of the solids. And this works out at 0.3, or 30%. That means that based on the density of our sandy gravel, we estimate that it has a porosity of 30%. In the next video, we'll see if this is correct or not. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and thank you very much for your attention.